These proposed multi-role fighter jets are expected to augment the existing fleet of 12 South Korean-made Mach 1.5 capable FA-50PH jet aircraft acquired from 2015 to 2017 by the Philippine Air Force as its first supersonic aircraft after the decommissioning its Northrop F-5 Freedom Fighter jet fighters in 2005. Throughout the years, the Philippine Air Force aspires to have many multi-role fighter jets in its inventory, even it predates way back two decades earlier on the original provisions of the AFP modernization program. The multi-role fighter jet is part of Horizon 2 of the Armed Forces of the Philippines modernization program, which is slated for 2018 to 2023 and aims to acquire more equipment for external defense. The idea of the Philippine Air Force plans of obtaining multi-role fighter jets in its inventory is definitely not the new one. The first of such plans coming out in the open dates way back the 1990s as the administration of then-President Fidel Ramos passed the original AFP modernization program or Republic Act 7898. The number of units should be obtained from the original program was composed of 3 squadrons, equated to 36 units of these multi-role fighter jets. McDonnell Douglas pitches to the Philippine government to bag the FA-18 fighter jets alongside other candidates, such as Lockheed Martin F-16 CD Block, Dassault Mirage 2005, and the Mikoyan Gurevich MiG-29, where it was demonstrated by the newly democratic Russian government that was also pitching at that time. However, such aspirations that almost went to fruition was simply disappeared as the region plunged in the 1997 Asian financial crisis that effectively affects the Philippines. For this reason, the economy takes time to recover, and as the change of tenures takes place as one administration takes over the other, this program wasn't materialized up to the point that the Philippine Air Force retires its last of F-5A Freedom fighter jets in 2005. It was only in recent times that this topic is being raised again and makes progress, starting from the organization coming back to the supersonic age upon purchasing the lead-in fighter trainer jet FA-50s from South Korea's Kaya Korean Aerospace Industries. From there, the aspiration for multi-role fighter jets is emphasized, given that these lead-in fighter trainer jets serve as an interim platform for primary protection of airspace at present, as well as a training platform for pilots before embarking on projects like this. Despite all of that, the program that is started in the original modernization program and wasn't made a reality that time somewhat provides the foundation in a sense that it shows a sense within the Air Force ranks where the dreams and aspirations of a fully modernized fleet of aircraft simply do not fade away. With all of the negotiations and assessments made, the time is getting closer that the project will materialize once a go signal is given. Throughout the years, the Philippine Air Force aspires to have many multi-role fighter jets in its inventory, even it predates way back two decades earlier on the original provisions of the AFP modernization program. The Philippine government, with the blessing of President Rodrigo Duterte, that this said project is about to get momentum, with funding sets to approval where eventually he approved it and paves the way for the further materialization of projects slated such as these capable flying assets.
Impossible dream to fight the unbeatable foe.